Okay, you've now successfully used Git to merge some branches. At this point, you might be wondering whether Git can always automatically determine how to merge branches. Let's think this through by taking a look at another simple example. In this example, just like in the last one, the original file contains a couple of lines, A, B, and D. Remember, these are just stand-ins for lines, not the content themselves. Again, like in the previous example, Jake's file and Rachel's file look a little bit different at the end of the day. This time, at the end of the day, Jake's file contains the lines A, B prime, and D, where B prime just stands for a modified version of B. And then Rachel's file at the end of the day contains A, B double prime, again another modified version of B, but not the same one as Jake's, and D. If it helps to think about this in more concrete terms, you can imagine that this file is a recipe, and that B is a line that calls for preheating the oven to 375 degrees. Then B prime, for instance, could call for preheating the oven to 400 degrees, and B double prime could call for 350. But again, this content really could be anything. Just like you did in the last exercise, consider for each line whether or not it should be in the final version. If you think it should be, mark it as yes. If you think it shouldn't, mark it as no. And if you don't think that we really have enough information, mark it as unknown.